Remote browser isolation is a key component that a lot of our customers are seeing huge benefit from. If we think about any attack, and it, you know, it's not limited to ransomware or a Trojan or anything like that, typically it's starting in a chain of events, or a kill chain as it's known, where the first element of the attack is usually an exploit. So an exploitation of a vulnerability in the browser itself, or something used by the browser to render various types of content. So, you know, Office files, PDF files, things like that. So the way that your systems are currently using, you know, if they're using a detection-based model, you have to then figure out whether something's good or something's bad in terms of that content reaching your users. So what browser isolation does is it seeks to remove that decision element from the equation. So essentially what we do is we create this air gap between the user and the internet. We do that by inserting this isolation platform between them and the internet as a secure layer where we can essentially move the execution point for code away from the endpoint. So simplistically, the way that it works is user would connect to the isolation platform. We spin up a disposable container. We use a browser within that container to essentially act on behalf of the user. So they would reach out to the internet, download the code and content, execute it in this container away from the user, and then we present the user with the information that would have been received by executing that content locally, only that execution point is moved away from the user. So the user essentially has this bulletproof glass, which they can browse freely, safely to the internet without any kind of, you know, harmful content ever reaching their machine. So we employ this for web browsing, for document isolation, for all different elements within our platform. And it's really the isolation core which powers our entire platform.